Hey there. Today is going to be a resin video. I am experimenting with ProMarine Supplies resin. It's a two-part process. The A is the tabletop epoxy, B is the epoxy hardener. And I've had several people recommend it, so this is what I'm trying today. And I've got a couple of different things I'm going to put resin on. One is a clock, and I put some screws in the bottom, and I've put some tape around the edge so that when it drips, it won't leave little knots on the bottom of it. I have cleaned this off with Dawn dish liquid and a damp paper towel and made sure all the silicone was off of the surface and cleaned it really well. And then I did a spray coat of varnish just very lightly to kind of seal it. So it already has a spray coat of varnish. And I put, this is for a clock. I've got tape in the middle to block the opening. I've got a 20 inch print on canvas that I put a clear coat on that I was not happy with. So I'm going to put a layer of resin on top of this. So it's already got a coat of varnish, and I'm going to resin on top. Figuring that I need about 20 ounces, I need to fill these cups up. These are 8 ounce cups, but it goes higher. It'll go to about 11 or 12. So I'm gonna start with the hardener first. So I'm going to do, I'll do 5 ounces. And I'm going to pour the hardener in and do another 5. I'm going to very slowly stir this. For about 3 minutes. I put too much in the cup. I'm going to transfer this into the bigger container. Okay, now I can stir better. I'm going to go ahead and mix up a bigger batch. I'm totally not experienced with this, so scraping around the edges of the container as well. And I understand that you stir this until it kind of gets cloudy. Continually scraping the sides. So now I'm going to transfer to this other container. Scraping the sides down. And I'm going to stir again for 3 minutes. There's lots of bubbles, but when you pour it, then you get to use a heat gun to help the bubbles go away. So I'm going to get my clock ready. I'm just going to tilt right now. Also, when I put the screws in on the bottom, underneath, I leveled out the piece to make sure that once it was standing on the screws, it would be level. So I'm letting this just go up right to the edge. I don't want a super thick coat on this. If at all possible, I want to be able to control it just a little bit. So now it's right up to the edge. So now it's, all the bubbles are pretty much gone, and I'm just going to tilt it a few times. That also loosened the resin up a little bit, so it's kind of running over all the edges, which is what I wanted. So I'm just running my fingers around to make sure that there's a coat of resin. And I have tape on the bottom side too, so that, you know, it'll keep it from getting those little drips that hang down and dry hard. So, and I see a couple little divots, so I'm just kind of just adding in a little bit there, but it looks pretty darn good. Gonna use my heat gun again. And I'm just dribbling where I see little areas that may have some divots, but it looks pretty good. And I'm gonna run my fingers around the edge again and along the bottom to make sure there's none dripping. And I will show you a video at the end of everything just to show you the finished product. This is my 20 by 20 canvas, and I have tape on the bottom, on the underside. Zoom out just a little bit here. I got my fan and the window open, and it's ventilating outwards. So now I'm going to pour this. And I'm not really sure how much I need. I think a little over 10 ounces. I have this Wilton cake tool. And this is like a jiggy jag edge. It's kind of up and down. I never used this part of it. So I saw where Jill Jackson uses something similar, and she pulls out her resin with her tool. So that's what I'm doing with this. Just dragging that resin out to the edges of the canvas. I've even seen people use their hands, their gloved hands. Just making sure it's distributed everywhere. And it goes over the edge. And I just need a really thin coat on this. I don't need a ton because it is just a print. I just thought it would make it look prettier. And then she said, just wipe your tool off with the paper towel. And what happens is it will dry, and you can use it over and over and over again. So we're going to see if that really happens. Okay, I'm going to keep pouring around the edge because I didn't know how much to use, and I'm pretty certain I have plenty, but I'm just going to play it on the safe side. Now I'm going to use my heat gun again. Okay, so I have two more to do. So I'm going to add four more cups. So I need about 7 or 8 ounces per canvas. I'm gonna do 8 each. So I'm gonna do 2 at one time. My poor heat gun has suffered. Okay, so I'm going to take my gloves off, and of course you can see the the light source, but just take you down on this level to see how shiny and clear it is. I got the fan out there with the window open, but I don't know if you can see the sparkle, but I'll try to get that afterwards. These are the metallics. So it just brings out all the metallics. So that is the two canvases. They're 12 by 16. And that probably took probably about 14 ounces of resin. And then a lot is huddled underneath as well, under the cups. But I will cover this. And I hope you enjoyed it. And I will put the end results at the end of the video. Thanks a lot. Well, I just had to throw this in here. This was underneath the resin that I did the other day. And I'm just finishing up the final video to show you the end product. But I wanted to show you, this is dry. Even butcher paper or craft paper that is, you know, like grocery bag. Even it looks beautiful with resin on it. Anything looks better with resin on it. I just don't like doing resin. That's my problem. It dried in all these little clumps, and I just wanted to show you that. Though, see how it brings out, this is the color of butcher paper or brown craft paper. And here it is with the resin on it. So it just shows you the depth that resin can bring out in something that is matte and porous. And then how it's sealed in and you get this fabulous effect. I just had to share that with you. So here are the four things that I did in resin. I put a towel down because I'm still going to use my nasty tabletop to do another pour on. But this is a print that I had made for a client. It's on a 20 by 20 inch canvas. So see how it's printed. It's even got a barcode and they send it this way. And I took it and put a coat of resin, and that shows you the reflection there. So this is actually over a canvas print, and even with the print, it just gives it so much more depth. Even though the print does not do the original artwork justice, adding this resin just took it to another level. So I wanted to show you that was one piece that I did. So here is my rainbow clock that I had done a few weeks ago. And so now I have a coat of resin on that. And I put the, I still have the back side, which I need to paint. I always paint the back on a clock, and I usually paint it black because it's going to just make it go away. I haven't put the battery in yet. So I've installed the clock mechanism, and I still have to put the numbers, which are just stick down numbers, but I was letting this get really cured good before I put the numbers on. But there is the resin clock, and it turned out pretty perfect. So I was very pleased with the clock. And here are the two companion pieces that I named Kendra 1 and 2. And they're on 12 by 16 inch canvases, and there's metallics in it. And without the light on, I don't know if you can see the metallic. It sparkles with the light on. So let me see if I can put some light on it for you. Okay, so I put the light on. I know you see the square of the light and the everything, but I wanted you to be able to see the shimmer of the metallics, but it really just does not do it justice. You can see a little shimmer there. But all these were metallics. Everything was metallics except for the red clay color. There's bronze and copper and pewter and gold. And so these were my two pieces that I did. And I just have one coat on them. I could do a second coat, but I'm not going to because resin is just not my thing. But there they are. And that shows you the shininess of resin, which you cannot come close to it with any kind of gloss paint, but it is a lot to work with. Resin is a lot to work with. You have to have the right environment, the right ventilation. It makes a big mess. So I even kept it pretty controlled on my tabletop this time, and I covered everything like I was supposed to, and so this experience was better than my first experience with resin, but I still don't love doing resin. So there they are. So I hope you enjoyed my resin experience. If you did, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And check out all the links below my videos where it says show more on your desktop or laptop or the down arrow on your mobile device. There's Facebook and Patreon and Amazon, PayPal, all kinds of links. And I usually list all my colors and products that I use. So thank you for following. There's a little shimmer there too with, of course, the light in the way, but you can see the sparkle. So thanks a bunch.